So, the day is finally here. The one that Mark and Howard have waited for a couple of years. The day when they tackle Helvellyn via Striding Edge. Helvellyn, the third highest peak in the Lake District and in England. Striding Edge, one where people fall off regularly and die. So, we're quite nervous, quite excited, and look forward to everything that this fell can throw at us. Here we go then. First port of call on top of that baby. You start out in Glenridding. You start in the Glenridding car park, park the car, it's very clearly signposted to Glenridding, and up you go. And that's the first port of call. And we haven't walked that high this year, so better get on with it. How do you feel about tackling Helvellyn and Striding Edge today?
To be honest, I'm quite nervous.
Why?
Because Striding Edge is about that wide. I don't think you can put 2 feet next to each other, let alone two people. But in for a penny, in for a pound, so yeah, I'm up for it. Why not?
I asked how you're feeling, not your price.
Yeah, a bit excited, a bit nervous, but I'm sort of ready and I'm up for it.
Of course, one of the downsides of fell walking in August, during the school holidays, on a popular Wainwright walk like this, is that you have to deal with lots of other walkers, and that may sound terribly antisocial, but we are terribly antisocial, and I don't intend to speak to anybody at all. So, Helvellyn via Myersbeck, which is 3 miles. Easy. We've already started going quite steep, but the way I look at it is not to worry about the aerobic struggles one may be having, but just think of the exercise that these very fat and flabby butt cheeks are getting. I start this walk with cheeks as flabby as the cheeks of Bernard Ingham.
Who the bloody hell's gonna know Bernard Ingham?
By the time I get back, these buns are cracking walnuts. Now, I don't want to be a bit bitchy, but I've noticed a lot of these walkers, they have quite sizable arses. So, you know, these exercises may do them the world of good as well, but by God, there's some fat asses. Oh, isn't it glorious, eh? So we've been walking for about 15 minutes, and already you can see the delightful Ullswater in the background. And what makes this even nicer is that we are going through one of the most glorious summers for years, 2014. And the sun is shining and I'm actually tempted to remove my cow t-shirt and walk topless. And then I thought, you know what? Who wants to see the body of a 50-year-old man with these moves swinging, one swinging one way, one swinging the other? It'll be like walking the fells with the cast of Ippitombi. Hossa, hossa, ho. No one will know what Ippitombi is, but I do.
It sounds funny.
It was a musical years ago in the 70s.
I think I know. So we're leaving Glenridding behind, way in the distance there, and we've got to the stage where you start to feel that pump in your heart and the shortness of your breath, and it's good. You sort of drop the bullshit and everything falls away and you just start to walk. It's good.
And talk bullshit?
Yeah, you still talk bullshit. Yeah. But the bullshit in your mind drops away, but you still talk bullshit.
good thing about this climb is that there's a rocky kind of staircase in this first section, so that makes it much easier, and it's very welcome, to be honest. So keep going, but it is quite tiring. Okay, so we've thought of a really jolly wheeze to have as we ascend to the top. When we pass people coming down, we're going to say in this rather posh voice, "Much further, much further, much further," and see what the response is, okay? So we'll see. Much further, do you think?
Sorry?
Do you think it's much further?
It's always much further. Never ends. That's the beauty of it. Why are we doing?
So we're an hour from Glenridding now, going up, and the views are just what you want from Lakeland. Look at this spectacular scenery, these fells and the colours and the stone and the lake in the distance. It's just beautiful, isn't it? Just beautiful, truly. So, an hour of endlessly going upwards, and my glutes are so solid. My butt cheeks, I'm just going to test them to see how strong they are. So let's see what happens if I crush this. Okay, so right there.
That's impressive.
Buns of steel. It's a relentless climb. Just up, 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 up. It never levels off. And it's warm, so a bit of a sweat getting on. Have you met my friend, Betty Swallocks? Oh, she's a character.
After leaving Glenridding and climbing for about an hour and a half, and you come up to the top here on the moor, and you get to see Helvellyn in the distance with Striding Edge and Swirl Edge, it's so majestic. It's such a proud, proud fell. Look, it's sturdy and strong. It's just exciting to see it. He's beautiful, really. He's a he, definitely. Unless he's called Helen. And then it'd be called Hell Helen.
Much further, Striding Edge. Striding Edge, not particularly. Where is it? Which one? You see those three lumps there, and then that's it, basically.
That's
Striding
Edge.
Goes up and down. And then you got the edge along to the top.
Is that what is the edge over the top of the third lump there?
Yes.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, I would have thought so.
So Helvellyn is where then?
So that's Helvellyn right there.
That's Helvellyn.
I came up that path.
Right.
And went around.
That way around.
Swirl Edge.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
is this down. Is this here Swirl Edge?
This
then?
One's here Swirl Edge.
Right.
And
okay.
You see where the hole there?
Yeah.
Tarn's in there.
Right, okay,
so
brilliant.
So that's where the tarn is.
All right, thank you.
All right.
Brilliant,
really
thank
helpful.
You.
Cheers.
Okay. That's great.
You're almost there.
Thank you.
You're almost there.
Much further?
About, say, 45 minutes or so.
Return so, to me. We near the beginning of the dreaded Striding Edge. Although there ain't much striding going on up there, I can tell you.
Hurry back, oh my love, hurry back, I am yours. Return to me, for my heart wants you only. Hurry home,
well,
won't you please?
Here we are then, Striding Edge, and it's a fantastic challenge. It's just a rock climb, so it's quite narrow, so you have to really have your wits about you, but it's fantastic. The views up here are exceptional. Come on, Hal, let's live dangerously.
Forgive me, and please say you are mine.
Here we go then, over the top of the edge. Fantastic.
Return to me. Please come back, bella mia. Hurry back, hurry home to my arms, to my lips and my heart.
There's literally 2 feet either side, so that's quite daunting.
Cara mia, ti amo. Solo tu, solo tu.
We're halfway along Striding Edge now, and we're having a little bit of a rest. And it's pretty much a scramble if you're going over the top. But there's lots of rock, and it's jagged enough so there's lots of grip. But one wonders how terrible it must be when it's raining or windy. I would have thought quite scary, to be honest. But in this weather, if you keep your wits about you, it's fine. But the views from up here are staggering. Goodness knows what they're like at the top of Helvellyn.